une organisation syndicale comme la CFDT,
a trade union such as CFDT is relatively comfortable with the 2030 agenda, relatively comfortable because its members and the employees it defends are workers, of course, but also consumers and citizens. And in this respect, we consider that we have our word to say about social issues. We're developing a claim, which is that of an economy of quality. What does that mean? It means a sustainable economy that is respectful of the environment, but that also comes with economic performance, which is perfectly consistent with the 17 Sustainable Development Goals. Of course, it's not just a question of theory or a domestic question. All of this needs to pervade every level, the level of companies, but also the level of communities, territories, where are the many things to be done. We have projects for industrial ecology on the domestic level, where laws and regulations are voted and enforced, but also internationally through our international organizations, essentially the European Trade Union Confederation, the CES, and the International Trade Union Confederation. They bring together no fewer than 176 million members, making it the greatest organization worldwide. Through these organizations, we can create democracy where democracy is absent. We can alleviate the suffering of people in authoritarian regimes. We also have the Institut Belleville within CFDT, where we work with lesser developed countries, and we work with trade unions in non-democratic countries too. And on every level, particularly the international level, trade unionism promotes democracy. But as a trade union, we must also educate and as much as possible implement what we require from companies ourselves. To take a concrete example, in Rennes we had a congress in early June and we made it an eco-congress. We've been doing that since our congress in Tours. What we do is that we're careful, we pay attention to our consumption of resources, water, power, plastic, and our CO2 emissions. I have just obtained the results for the Rennes Congress, and we have reduced our CO2 emissions by 20%, which is not so bad. If one considers that we were in the midst of an SNCF strike. So this is encouraging. It also allows us to educate about the carbon footprint and why carbon balance needs to be made in order to reduce pollution, and our 623,000 members may in future be convinced that sustainable development is the future. If we have lowered our consumption by 20%, much remains, and what we do is compensate that. And this year we selected two projects, one in Ghana, an energy transition project, and another project in Asia, in Cambodia, for the development of agriculture. So in more concrete terms, how can CFDT reflect the 17 SDGs? Some of them are natural, of course, those that are social in nature. Many would like to restrict us to that, but we consider that all of the goals need to be apprehended in order to be effective in sustainable development. Let me take one example, biodiversity, which is on the face of it not a concern for a trade union, but biodiversity is the survival of humankind. How can we not consider, therefore, that biodiversity is not important? We have employees working full-time in these sectors. We have many contacts with NGOs who are specialized in these issues. And the CFDT project around what I called an economy of quality is a project that encompasses all of the dimensions of sustainable development and the 17 SDGs. Our action focuses essentially In the corporate world, there are several manners in which we can act: conventional action with union representatives in various bodies, but also a claim to a co-decision power, meaning that the union representatives play a much more important role in corporate boards to make sure that sustainable development is integrated into a corporation's goals. What we are claiming and obtaining, and what we have made progress in this field, is the presence of employee directors in the boards who are there to look out for the general interest of the employees, but also to promote an environmentally respectful company with good performance in terms of working conditions, social conditions, and economic efficiency. In all of this, CFDT also had an influence on the draft legislation, the PACT law. There are many things in that that we do not like, but there is one that we find interesting. We originated it in part. It's the modification of the French Civil Code, Article 1833, which defines what the purpose of a company was. Until now, the only purpose of a company was economic and profit. Tomorrow, it will more likely be the possibility for companies to have a social purpose or an environmental purpose. We cannot really measure the efficiency of such measures, but it's a turning point. And if we do this properly, we'll be able to move forward. We need to see the world as it really is today. We need to imagine the world of tomorrow and to find our path between the two. It's a transition that needs to be socially fair for employees. Employees must be stakeholders in this transition. To take a concrete example, the path to be followed in transition means looking at the skills and the evolution of tomorrow's jobs to make sure that today's employees have the skills for tomorrow's employment. That is what drives us, motivates us, pushes us to move forward, and means that our children tomorrow will live in a desirable and sustainable world.